It's a near-death experience. That's how former Senator Leila de Lima described Sunday's ordeal when she was taken hostage by a fellow detainee inside her detention cell at the Philippine National Police Custodial Center, which is right in the heart of the PNP's headquarters in Camp Crame, Quezon City. Three detained members of the terrorist group Abu Sayyaf tried to escape the facility on October 9. Two were shot and killed as they tried to flee, while one of them briefly held de Lima hostage when authorities caught up with him. PNP Chief Rodolfo Azurin Jr. told ABS-CBN's Teleradio de Lima is unhurt and safe after her hostage taker was neutralized by responding operatives.
Nag-umpisa dito sa pag-serve ng pagkain, then it was taken advantage ng ating POPCs until na-neutralize yung dalawa, although yung si Sulayaw hindi siya tinamaan, yan nakapunta kay sa quarters ni Senator De Lima. And later, nagkaroon ng negotiation about 10 to 15 minutes. Pero nakikita natin na habang tumatagal, nagiging dangerous yung situation ng ating senador. So we have to end the situation. So doon napunta sa neutralization ni Sulayo.
Umihingi na kung ano-ano ng hammer, ng helicopter, etc. Pero mabilis mag-isip si Colonel Pespes. Nung siya hininga ng tubig, biligyan niya yung tubig na paganito. Pagbigyan niya ng tubig, ito yung kanyang kanang kamay. Binaril niya sa ulo.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. tweeted about the incident on Sunday, saying that he would ask De Lima if she would like to be transferred to another facility. But Interior Secretary Benhur Abalos says she has declined. Police are now investigating the incident.
Ang sabi naman kanina sa akin ni Senadora is that okay na, dito na lang ako sa akin ngayon dahil safe naman daw siya. She feels really very safe.
Former Senator De Lima is still recovering from Sunday's traumatic experience. In a statement, she said a pointed object, possibly a screwdriver or ice pick, was pointed at her chest. She was also blindfolded by her captor. De Lima thanked the police for saving her life. She also thanked her supporters who all raised concerns after finding out about the incident. She adds, it was farthest from her mind that such a thing would happen to her after already suffering more than 5 years of what she called unjust detention. De Lima has been detained since 2017 for drug-related charges, allegations that the former Justice Secretary vehemently denies.
The hashtag Free Leila Now trended on social media Sunday. That's as human rights groups and her allies repeat their plea for the former senator to be finally set free. Among them, De Lima's allies, former Vice President Lenny Robredo, who also offered prayers for those injured in the incident. Human rights lawyers Chel Jocno and Erin Tanyada hope the cases against her will be soon dropped. Members of the Senate minority, Senators Coco Pimentel and Risa Ontiveros, meanwhile, want the PNP to explain what happened.
Responsibilidad ko na makita siyang personal at alamin ang kanyang kalagayan.
The Commission on Human Rights, meanwhile, expressed concern about what happened as they fear for the safety of detainees. Human Rights Watch also expressing support for De Lima, saying it's about time De Lima walk free.
The Philippine President's sister, Senator Aimee Marcos, urges De Lima to agree to go on house arrest following Sunday's hostage-taking at Camp Crame. Marcos notes De Lima was already offered the home furlough option as early as July. She says she's worried about the former senator's health and safety, adding that she should undergo a medical checkup with her own physician.
We have this just in. The head of the custodial service unit, where former Senator Leila de Lima is detained, has been relieved from his post. That's while authorities conduct an investigation into Sunday's hostage-taking incident. Philippine National Police Chief Rodolfo Azurin Jr. says de Lima's captor was trying to look for the exits but was probably confused by the maze-like layout of the custodial facility, which is why he ended up in de Lima's cell. He adds they are already looking at ways to further tighten security measures in the premises.
Nilagay muna natin na OIC yung deputy para na sa ganun ay siya na muna ang magpalakad ng custodial center. Si Senator De Lima kagabi po ay dilipat po na siya pansamantala sa PNP General Hospital para makapagpahinga po siya habang inaayos po ang kanyang facility kasi doon nga po nangyari yung insidente. So medyo nililinis pa po na inaayos and naghahanap po tayo ng ibang facility doon sa loob ng custodial center na pwede po niyang paglipatan para yun pong kahit pa paano hindi po niya naalala yung naging insidente.